Let's look a little more specifically at this marvelous big old 50-year-old plum. The variety Santa Rosa, an early plum and an exquisite plum. It's perfumed and it's sweet with good balancing acidity. As mentioned, this was a full-size tree, 20 plus feet. And we decided about 10 or 15 years ago to bring it down in height as much as we could. Now let me say, you can't take a 20 plus foot tree and make it into a 6 foot tree. But you can take it and about halve its size, which we've done here. So we did that with a series of cuts that would be called renewal cuts. Let's look at a couple and our advanced thinking as we went along and the tree's response. This branch went up another 15 feet or so. And so we renewed it by cutting it way back, basically to an exaggerated stub. And what was the tree's response as a wound response? It did a number of things. It developed a ton of really vigorous upright shoots here. We selected one and did this early in the first growing season after we rescaffolded, and we did it with a simple tool, my index finger. We just finger pruned the unwanted branches out, left one and grew that. It grew, we headed it in the winter, it grew, we headed it in the winter and on. And as you can see up above here, we have a reestablished scaffold. That was good thinking and it was pretty spot on. And yet, and this happens with all fruit trees over time, the term is that the fruit wood migrates up the branch, up and out into the sunlight. It takes at least 50% of the total of 100% of sunshine falling from the sky, striking a branch to manufacture and maintain quality fruit buds. So over time, the top of the tree gets all the light and is fruitful and shades the base. So there comes the term, the fruit wood migrates up the tree, i.e. the bottom of the branch is bare and lifeless. So we thought about that and as we watched that set of phenomena happening, and we thought, maybe we could do this differently. So let's look over my shoulder here at another example. So instead of renewing the tree at about head height, we went down to about thigh high. We made that wicked, radical renewal cut, leaving a stub, and this is the new issuance. And this is a good response. As you can see, it goes, it's still a young branch. So this tree is 50 years old, but the effective fruiting wood is about 3, 5, 7 years old. All trees bear best on young wood. So I have an old framework with some young, lively fruit wood. So this goes up and you can see the fruit wood is down here, not just way up top. How accessible is this? The answer is very. The old adage is, with tall trees, if you can't prune it, you certainly can't thin or pick it. So this makes for quicker work, safer work, more enjoyable work. Okay, a variation on a theme, renewing scaffolds. No doubt you've heard the phrase, the best laid plans of mice and men often go awry. It's the title of a John Steinbeck novel, actually except Grapes of Wrath, most of his stuff were novellas. And he stole it from the Scottish poet Robert Burns, and I don't know who Burns stole it from. But I have an old friend, Ron Tyler, retired county fruits and nuts specialist, ag agent for Santa Cruz County. And he once called this renewing of scaffolds the kill it or cure it technique. I showed you a curate one over there. Now, in all humility, I say, sometimes this doesn't work so good. Did not work. But yet it did. I tried a half a dozen branches, a complete working over and renewing of the scaffold, and I got one that responded. And that's a little sad, but that's okay. Off of this, I'm going to form a new tree up a little higher. And what this speaks to is incrementalism. It is far better, as we did over there, to renew a few branches in the entire framework over a period of a few years rather than one fell swoop.
Whenever you're ready.
Let's now look at a successful complete rescaffolding of the whole framework of a Santa Rosa plum. So as you can see, and this happened about 3 or 4 winters ago, I've made renewal cuts throughout the tree, all the way around, just stubbed it from 15, 20 feet to head high. And I got a successful response. As you can see here, here, and yet again over here, and by extension all around the 360 degrees of the trunk, we have some nice, lively, bronzy, upright growth that is very fruitful. These are all fruit buds. So I've got a nice 8-10 foot tree here that I'm still bringing along. It's bearing, but not yet full canopy or mature, but I'm on the road to rescaffolding and success. And I'm doing it in a way that I can almost totally manage this tree, whatever the needs are for inputs from the ground, or maybe do a little pruning and thinning with a long arm pruner. Maybe I have to get a stepladder assistance, go up a couple feet on a short ladder to pick. But I'm in much better shape for having my fruit wood down low where I can manage it quickly, safely, and enjoyably.
Okay, whenever you're ready.
So coming full circle regarding renewing the scaffold of big old trees, tall trees. You can do it incrementally or you can do it in one fell swoop. My strong recommendation is to do it incrementally. So back to this original tree here. We probably have 8 or 9 major primary scaffold branches. So a good approach is to renew these branches, all of them, yeah, but over time. Do 2 or 3 a year. It's less traumatizing to the tree, and you have a much higher success rate. Additionally, you'll be able to eat fruit while you're rescaffolding. So if you've got 9 limbs, do 2 or 3 in year 1, year 2 do another third, year 3 do the last third, and you'll be in pretty good shape. And this is something you can do with big old trees, whether they're well tended or neglected.